Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back to the stage, Mr. Adam Pennington.
Hey. Welcome back from lunch, you know, if it was provided by us or provided at your own home. Hopefully as you went outside, if you're here, you got a chance to see the sponsor tables we have downstairs. Encourage you to come by, visit them, say hi. Most of them have swag, we promise. So you go check it out. So our first talk after lunch, we have the first of our attack updates. So this is going to be talking about defensive attack by Lex Crumpton.
Is it this button?
The big green one.
Okay. It's the big green gun. Goodbye, guys. Okay, awesome. Yeah, my name's Lex. I'm here to give you guys the defensive attack updates. Finally. Let's see if this works. Come on. There we go. That was a good hair day. So I'm the lead cybersecurity engineer for MITRE. I just got there last June. Before that, I was a former exploitation developer turned blue, and I never looked back, okay? That's a very important thing. I led quite a few teams, digital forensics, threat hunting, detection. My canine child, he's like this big, and he jumps on me all the time. And then this last one is a joke, because all you see is work stuff, but I actually do some fun stuff too. I like playing video games, PS4, look me up. I like doing street photography. You see me out there actually taking pictures of crazy people doing crazy things. And I actually grow vegetables and herbs to like heal people's bodies, like creams, ointments, teas, all those things. So welcome to the other side of MITRE attack. Again, finally, I finally worked Jamie down enough where he gave me this talk. This is going to incorporate mitigations, data sources and data components, detections, and of course, CAR. Specifically for this talk, we're gonna be looking into detections and CAR, but just know my area encompasses all of these areas. We started this update in V5 with mitigations, and then subsequently in V10 with data sources and data components. And between those two, we have the mapping to risk control frameworks, which is a really good thing. And then also letting defenders know what data to collect. So where are we? This is what happened after V10. This bottom portion right here gives me so much anxiety, okay? I don't know what it's saying, and a lot of other people don't know what it's saying either. So the changes that we're gonna do in V11 is this. We're gonna be breaking out that detection paragraph into their data components so that you have a better understanding of what the detection and what defenders need to collect overall, which is a very good thing, right? This gives me less anxiety. There's some order here, you guys, okay? Next up, you'll see that we're gonna try and make a cohesive kind of detection statement overall. Monitor executed commands and arguments. Analyze curated processes, files, registry keys. Look for IP addresses or port numbers or protocols that you should be looking for defenders overall. And then next, we're gonna try and give you that little bit of in-depth that you're gonna need that says what exactly you're looking for. Process names, registry key paths, command lines and arguments that are gonna tell you exactly what you need to know as a defender in this space. So where do we go from here? How can I improve this work? Because this took a lot of work, you guys. Coming soon, of course, we're gonna have data sources into all the other domains. So ICS, cloud, mobile, macOS, Linux. We're gonna try and get us all on one page, because I like to work together, and so that we can all have things that tell defenders as a community what we need to look for. Again, please note the coming soon, okay? Next, we have the Cyber Analytic Repository. This started in 2013-2016, but we fully intend to give it a 2.0 upgrade. This is the place where we could build analytics to give a more in-depth view of what is going on for defenders. And we fully intend to align this to the MITRE attack detections. So that means data models are going to be more synced across the board. That means anything that is not in MITRE attack detections is going to be in the cyber analytic repository and a more in-depth view of what exactly you need to know. So just to recap, because I said a lot of things, What we're looking forward towards the future, we're going to have cross domains against ICS, cloud, mobile, macOS, Linux. We're going to align detections with data sources and data components so that we get a better understanding of what you're looking for. We're going to incorporate the cyber analytic repository and try to give that a full upgrade in what's coming soon. And then, of course, things that are not on this slide, mitigations and anything updates to, you know, the famous debate of command execution compared to process creation. I've heard the emails, okay. It is going to change, I promise you that. And then, of course, we can't leave out mitigations. You know, we did get that risk control framework update, but how can we push that further into mapping it to the new techniques? How can we push that further to incorporate, you know, the protect, defend, and detect scenarios across the board? And how can we improve our defensive posture overall for MITRE attack? Short, sweet, and to this point. My name is Lex. You can find me on Twitter. And I'm open for any questions.
And this is really a topic that we're really excited about, as you can tell. Something that we recognized from the very first ATT&CKcon. We saw the CFPs, but the presentations really highlighted the, you know, how much power, how much attention, how much kind of potential we have with the defensive side of attack. So I've been an honor working with you, and we're really excited for the future. And regarding the question earlier, it is something where we're, as most things in attack, we're leaning towards you. You know, we built it, we're open to feedback, we wanted to grow this, we want to new use cases, more depth, more, you know, breadth into different platforms, all of that is on the table. So Lex, unfortunately, is not going to be on the couch, but great news is we have plenty of time right now. So let's go around the room. You know, any questions? I already got one.
So one of my favorite things is relationships and correlations, and I'm excited about this car upgrade. So what I want to know is, could you just give me a little sneak peek? If you were mentioning that you'd be able to better correlate with the data sources, data components, are you saying that perhaps we would be able to have the relationships between them and the car analytics? Is that what you're saying?
So just for a repeat for the live audience, the question was, you know, getting into those, the future of car and the really integration of data sources, components, and analytics and all that logic. You know, what is it? What is the future of, you know, car and the correlation between, you know, analytics and logic, and, you know, this, these objects that we're creating regarding data sources and data components?
Yeah, so really good question, and I'm still trying to figure that out. Now, I think the one aspect of car is that it can give us the platform to go really in depth. And so, as you look at their data models, they have the process, they have the networking, and then they have two levels below that, and they have, I believe, the nitty-gritty details of each data source, or in their case, their umbrella platform. And so being able to take, like we saw for command execution, or the command scripter, scripting interpreter, what exactly are you looking for in regards to the log files that you need to look at, taking the digital forensics, the threat hunting, and the detections perspective, and saying, what am I supposed to see? What do I see in the prefetch files? What do I see in the shim cache? What do I see in any other type of log files that can help defenders build better analytics? And so we can't really take up the platform because we know we have Sigma and Elastic and all those other analytic repositories. So how can we be different? And so that's a key thing that we're trying to figure out right now.
Exactly as Lex implied. It starts with that common language. So now that we have a common language, you know, we can build around, you know, data sources, components, extend that to car, and really connect those dots where, you know, ideas that we're kind of, you know, prototyping, experimenting in the car domain, maybe over time that matures is something we can actually apply into attack and say, you know, this actually makes sense in a broad perspective. So it really is, you know, I'm really excited to see what you do, really balancing and kind of making those very interesting and very unique projects play off each other. Question. So the question for the live audience is, you know, MITRE is known for making frameworks. We love a good PowerPoint. We love a good white paper. But what's kind of the future of tying together multiple projects like, you know, Defend, and we have Engage, and we have MITRE Attack? In short, we internally recognize and respect that these are very different projects, but they're very different philosophies. So we are, you know, interested in, you know, learning from each other. Rather, you know, if one framework has an interesting idea that is applicable, consuming that. That said, really building those static kind of brittle connections. You know, in the past, we've, you know, struggled, you know, every project has its own cadence, every project has its own philosophy. Really putting those, you know, neck and neck sometimes is problematic. So I think more, you know, Adam can probably allude to this later in a following comment, but keeping it more informal where, you know, the knowledge is being transferred, but not necessarily framework to framework connections is probably the sweet spot. Great question, though. I think I saw a couple more hands. We have about 4 minutes. Don't be shy. But one thing, I guess while we wait for people to kind of stew on potential ideas, the question I had for you was, you know, I was obviously there, watching you kind of come from a very practitioner-focused, like, you know, doing day-to-day digital forensics, doing blue teaming, and then kind of growing into what we were good, the framework kind of high-level approach. What advice would you give for someone, you know, kind of in that same experience, like, you know, maybe a hands-on detection engineer or a threat hunter, yeah. And, you know, you see this, like, data sources and data components, and you're like, maybe some of that jargon, you know, vibe, some of it's a little bit new. What advice would you give someone kind of, you know, making that first step into, hey, I really want to start to see how I fit and see myself within this framework?
Ooh, that's a good question. So, like Jamie said, I came from a digital forensics background as well as a developer. So if you don't know about developers, they're always in the weeds, literally in the kernel, building with API calls and getting down to the bits and bytes, the ones and zeros, whatever. So I'm very focused on the details. And so getting into MITRE TACK, it was a very hard lesson from Jamie to pull back and think abstract, think very abstract. I would say that every portion of MITRE TACK has the base level knowledge. And so things like command execution and process creation, right? I mentioned this. What exactly is command execution doing? Is it using a process? Are you looking at the CLI? Are you looking at, you know, the bash history and it's just a log file? You have to understand what the base level is and apply that to MITRE ATT&CK. You can't just go through with it and say, let's get to the details because I know what it is. You have to take your knowledge out of it and look at the base level and the abstract level.
I wish we could pull up another Schitt's Creek meme. I think there's a, I have a GIF for yeah. it, a GIF, as Adam would say, directly related to that. But I think we're coming on time, so we maybe have time for one more question from the audience. Over here.
Yes. So did you want to repeat the question first?
Oh, yes. So I forgot my job. Thank you. yes. So the question is right now we have within the ATT&CK model, it's data sources, the data components, the techniques. In the future, is there any thought towards making the mapping down to the procedure level? Because we know within a technique or a sub-technique, there's so much variance regarding, you know, the procedures and kind of, you know, the implementation of a technique may differ between adversaries, between over time. There's so much opportunity for creativity there.
Yeah, and my answer to that is CAR. That's where that's going to lie. Keeping MITRE detections very abstract. Like, what are you exactly you're looking for? The verb, the noun, and then the action. And then going into CAR and saying, okay, there's different levels. Like I mentioned, you have your threat hunters, you have your digital forensics, you have your detection engineers. What exactly are they looking for on those different levels? And how can we apply the detections for those defenders?
A very selfish final question here is, if this intrigued anyone here or anyone in their live stream or, you know, watching this 6 months, 2 weeks, you know, whatever amount of time later, how do people contribute ideas and what are you looking for?
Ooh, this is my favorite question. So I, in the public MITRE ATT&CK Slack channel, we started the defensive ATT&CK channel. So please come visit me there. I'm normally like, looking on people on Mondays. So if you ever have anything on Mondays, I'm always there. Of course, you can always hit me up on social media, Twitter, Flex on the Hunt has a pun there. And then also the email that Jamie gets bombarded with all the time.
They keep
always,
coming.
Yeah, they always get to me somehow. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.